Roll call.
Ms. Alperi?
Absent.
Ms. Alcurie?
Present.
Mr. Andronopoulos?
Here.
Mr. Donovan?
Here.
Mr. Grillo?
Here.
Ms. Jarvis?
Here.
Ms. Malinak?
Here.
Mr. Musto?
Here.
Mr. Bruno?
Here. Annual notice of this meeting has been provided by the following means. Annual notice was sent to the Herald Union, the Record, the South Bergen, and the Observer, Township Clerk, and posted in the lobby of the Town Hall and Board Office, setting forthcoming scheduled work meetings and public meeting of the Board. The motion to approve the minutes of meetings.
So moved.
Roll call.
Ms. Alcurie?
Four.
Mr. Andronopoulos?
Four.
Mr. Donovan?
Four.
Mr. Grillo?
Four.
Ms. Jarvis?
Four.
Ms. Malinak?
Four.
Mr. Musto?
Four.
Mr. Bruno?
Four. Jason Cry. Come on up here, Jack. Oh, now you're gonna be there?
Good evening. My name is Jason Cry, 217 Lake Ave, right in town. My question is in regards to the aftercare program. I'm just curious as to why the parents weren't notified about the change, and why no one seeks any information from the parents that participate in the program. Number two, I'm also curious about how the new program is going to run, what the registration is going to be, and when the program is going to start. Also, is the new program going to be a smooth transition in the upcoming school year, or is the old program going to be continued to run for the upcoming school year, seeing as registration was already taken, and then transition over to this new program? Thank you.
First of all, no one was notified because we haven't voted on it until tonight. Once that's done, the person who is awarded the contract will put out notification. Is the transition going to be smooth? I would say it's going to be very smooth. The same people that run the summer camp for 352 kids that they had to stop because they couldn't take anymore and has run smoothly for the last 10 years are going to be the same people running the aftercare program.
Sorry, are we ordering?
No, I'm answering this question. He wants to know what the transition is going to be like.
I don't know who won.
Yeah.
I don't know who
won. Okay. Would you like to vote?
There's some questions.
All right, Jay, then I can't answer your questions. Come on up later. After we vote, and I will be sure to answer your question.
No, sir, I think that's concerned that we're awarding a contract. Are we awarding a contract?
I'm not awarding a contract. We're accepting.
Accepting what?
Accepting the person or the township that is being awarded the before and after care program. And if in case maybe you weren't here because you left a little early, on the executive meeting, we did have a vote, and then you were supposed to get back to me with your answer, which you never did, and I waited for Mr. Donovan for the same thing, never got an answer from him.
Okay.
You were supposed to read the proposal.
When was that vote? At the end of the meeting?
Yeah, it was during the meeting. We took the vote on what, no, not, I'm sorry, let's go back. Everyone was supposed to notify me by Wednesday what their vote was. Wednesday.
Thursday, you said.
Thursday, well, you still didn't get back.
No, I didn't, because I still didn't know what it was all about.
So, you didn't know what it was about, correct me, thanks. So you had to know what it was about. But anyway, to not argue here in front of everyone, everyone answered except Mr. Musto, Mr. Donovan, and their votes all went one way. Okay, so 6-2, and forgive me for skipping a few lines, but we'll get there. Okay?
Jason?
Yes, ma'am.
So I just want to speak from a different perspective. As a parent myself, I completely understand your concerns, and I think they're very valid questions, and I'm sure you're very anxious to have the questions answered. While I can't speak on behalf of the board and what's going to happen tonight based on your votes, I can tell you that we always keep students' best interests in mind. And when we keep students' best interests in mind and it comes to transition, those transitions have to be incredibly smooth. And in order to keep students' best interests in mind, we have to make those transitions equally satisfactory for parents as well. So I think that your questions are extremely valid. In anything that we do, we always look to either be equal to a current program we have in place or something better than. So that is what we're striving for. And I assure you that I think what the board is looking to do is to have opportunities to look at other programs that might provide us the opportunity to give our students more opportunities, to give our parents a little more flexibility in their needs, have a little bit more opportunity to maybe pick and choose what program is going to be best for them and have a menu from which to pick. And also just recognize that, you know, times financially are difficult for many families. And we want to make sure that families in need of good aftercare are able to get that through our schools and don't have to go to outside services for that. So those were some of the driving factors behind the board's decision to go out and see what other options were available. And the same process was used with this, as is used with any service that we have that's outside of our control. Our technology people are hired each year on RFQ. You know, our attorneys go out on RFQs. So really, the intent is always just to find the best for our students and hope that what's best for our students would be equally best for parents as well. And that is never to say that a program of any sort, whether we're speaking on this topic or another, is not satisfactory. It's just our desire to keep looking for what is out there and what our other options are.
So when you're basing your decision on your vote tonight, you're able to compare to the existing program and then judge by the bits that were placed. This is better than what's currently going on. This does not meet our needs. That's how you're making the decision.
So just to be clear, this decision is a board decision, mm-hmm. right? Okay, so that's a board decision. It would be unfair for me to speak on their behalf. Mm-hmm. But what I can speak about is the process. Our attorney could do the same to explain to you. When we go out on an RFQ, we're looking for any group that's interested in providing a service for the district to lay out everything within the requirements of the RFQ and anything else that they'd like to add in as well. So it is based on those submissions that are laid out and compared and discussed and decisions are made.
Okay, to address the board, okay? In regards to the decision you're going to make, okay? I'm a little surprised that no one has reached out, like I said, to the parents to get their feedback in regards to when you are making your decision, keep in mind, this is what we utilize the program for. This is what we need on a whole from the standpoint of the parents when they drop their kids off. Okay, an example I can give you right now. I drop my daughter off every morning between 7:45 and 8 o'clock in order to get to work. Don't work a 9-to-5 job. Okay, if I'm not available, my wife can drop my daughter off between 7:30 and 7:45, enabling her to drop her other child off at the sitter and allowing her to get to work on time. Is that taken into consideration while looking at the new program that we're going to choose?
Absolutely.
Okay, so that's basically, I don't have to worry about.
I can more than assure you it will be equal or better. Okay?
Okay.
Now, you know me?
I do, yes.
I coached you?
Yes, you do.
Am I lying?
No, I'm just here trying to get the facts. Okay. Like I said,
so
I don't know.
Know what I'm telling you is the absolute truth. And no one is going to lie to any of the parents here. As Mrs. DeMarco has said, the only thing we have in our interest is your children. Okay, and that's why we're sitting up here. And after it's presented, if you can honestly come back and say, wow, I don't think this is good, then we'll have a conversation. But I think after it's presented,
Okay.
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 Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Elaine. Is this agenda or non-agenda? Agenda. I see you have a doctrine of necessity here on there. What is this on the in here for?
Doctrine of necessity is invoked each month by the school board with regards to conflicts of interest in certain committees, and I'm sure that you're aware of why it's invoked. You do it as a blanket motion every month under rules and regulations so that board members are allowed to participate in committee meetings and discuss certain items. That if we didn't invoke this doctrine of necessity, they would not be able to. And then in certain instances, not saying the board at any time is in conflict with every member, but if we didn't invoke the doctrine of necessity, we wouldn't be able to conduct business.
Okay, so you do know the other law, 18A-12-24-1, Code of Ethics, the school board members too? I don't see that here. Okay. And you A-12-24.1, which is the Code of Ethics, also for the school board members.
But the Code of Ethics, though, for the school board members, when I swear them in January, okay, I believe that we went around the dais. I believe there was 10 items that were read, and someone went back around. I believe each one read one of the items, and the 10th one was was read into the minutes by the first person that read. We enacted the ethics code for the board back on January 4th or 5th when we reorganized.
Mm-hmm. Okay, on your request for a proposal before the before and after school program, is that on this agenda? The request for a proposal for the
He was on their new business for the board to vote on, yes.
It's on there, so I can speak on it then, right?
Yes, it's an agenda.
Okay.
I think you're pretty astute, though. You know how the agenda goes, so I think.
Well, I'm sorry I was down at the other place, so I didn't do it. I understand that the person who was here for years was doing a pretty decent job and was actually had certified people for the children, and they did more academics than what the other request for proposal is, which is the Parks Department. Now, being that said that with the Parks Department, I have documentation here that puts Mr. Bruno in a predicament where he may be in violation with number F on the Code of Ethics, because it seems to have been a political campaign statement made on a community pride ticket about how your people were going to do that back before the election happened. And I have concern about that. Because to me, it sounds like political retribution against the person who was doing it for years, when all you had to do was ask her for some information if she could compensate anything in the
for the school board and using the truck person, the drivers or whatever. But instead, they decide to go to the parks where, in a request for proposal, they do not show a background of history. They do not show the things that were qualified, which means that should be thrown out because it's not meeting the request for proposal. Because there's no history of the before and after school program ran by the Parks Department. You do realize this is going to go into further action.
This particular request that went out was not a request for proposals. The request for proposals, the way that they're written, the requirements for them are different than they are for a request for qualifications or request for information. They're different things. This one that went out was a request for an RFP or request for qualifications.
Okay.
And what it is, let's ask them the information that they're looking to gather, it's very different than it is for a request for proposals.
Okay, so either way, we require history and background.
That's one of the things that's requested in the RFQ is.
Right, but how could you even accept something that was never done before where there was a program?
Well, nothing's been accepted yet, they just requested it.
Well, I'm not bringing it to all people because before you vote on it, you got to understand there is like something like this would normally get thrown out, but because it's political, they want to put it in. So it creates a problem for me for the kids because you're really not looking with the best interest of the children, you're looking in the best interest of what is politically correct.
Okay.
And that has to stop.
Oh, I understand what you're saying. If this particular request was for qualifications, it's a little bit different.
Yeah, but what do you do qualifications of a place that you never did it before? Before and after school program. I'm not talking about the summer camp, I'm not talking about any of the things. And I also have a problem with the fact that why does the town get involved and do it? Well, this is up to everybody, because if you're going to do any requests, do you do it on the plumbing? Do you do it on all these other things and look for people too? Or are you just picking on this one particular item?
From what I understand, and again, maybe I haven't done this personally here.
Well, they all know what I'm talking about. And I'm asking the board to really consider what you intend to do. Because Mr. Bruno, according to this, you'd be in violation. If you
let me say this to you. The only violation that occurred was me being harassed, harangued, and belittled by a prominent figure, the number one person in town, okay? And it happened more than once. I have everything here on my phone, screenshot. I would be glad to share that with you at the meeting so you can see, okay? And a letter that went out to the public, that you're talking about political, the letter that went out to the public before the night of the election mentioned me in that, saying that I was standing up for one side or the other, which was absolutely false. I had no stake in it. And I went that night and told the public that it was absolutely wrong, that I had no hand in the letter that went out, and only that, in fact, a couple of board members were with me when I got the phone call, and it so bothered me that I had to leave the academic awards, okay, that I was threatened, okay, with actionable lawsuits, okay, for something that I hadn't done, all right? So if you're here and you're accusing me of something, then please come out and tell me what you're...
I'll show it to you what I have.
That's good, come on.
But my thing is I was at the diner that night, that day.
You were what?
I remember when I was at the diner that day, when you were sitting
Listen,
there.
Listen, I don't know what we're talking about here. We have a Board of Education meeting. I'd be glad to sit down with you after the meeting, and we could have a cup of coffee down the diner, because that's what you're talking about. And I'd be more than happy to discuss
it. Well, I'm just
But these people are not here worried about what was said down the diner.
Okay, well, my whole thing is that you have a program for all these years that was working good. Okay, if you were...
It was working good for some.
Yeah, but it was working good for a lot of people. But even people in the school...
When we get to what's in the program for what's coming up, the people there will understand what I'm talking about. But to stand there and throw accusations up here, it's not going to work because I've been through them. And I've been through them with the head guy. So it's not going to work.
But I don't think that maybe the arts department is going to be as good for the children as the other ones.
You don't know that. And the only ones to make that decision are the people sitting out there. They will let you know whether or not the parks department is going to be able to handle it. Okay?
It is going to handle it. It never did before.
Well, you know what? I think they've had a pretty good run at it with 350 or 360 kids. How many people out there are your children involved in the summer program? Raise your hand, please. Okay, quite a few of you. Those are the same people going to run. And if there is a problem, bring it to the Board of Education and we will handle it. If you sit there and not know what's going to happen, or not know how a program is going to run, or know anything that was in the RFQs, it's ridiculous for you to stand there and accuse people.
Well, to me, it sounds very political.
To you?
Yes.
Fine. You know what? To me, it was political too. Would you like to see my phone?
You can show me your phone and I can show you the paperwork. But let me tell you something. All I'm asking is that you need to really put the kids first and do what's best for the kids. Wait a minute, let me speak. There's a difference of babysitting your kids and there's a difference of the person having an academic program. Okay, so there's two different things you really have to look at. And I wondered all of you guys even read all that stuff that was given to you.
Yes, they did. In fact, they were given in 2 days and everyone got back to me except two.
Well, I see that there's going to be another crossover between the town using their stuff and then, you know, the other one would be used to pay the school.
Elaine, the only people that are going to decide that are the people sitting out there with their children, okay? And if they can come back and tell us that this program that we institute, whichever one it is, it's not like it should be, then we have to reassess what we're doing.
Okay, but let me ask you this. If this person's been here for like 6-7 years, when they have problems or not, and she was doing a good program, then all of a sudden, decide to change it in their campaign literature before the school, before the election, and all of a sudden now you want to do what the parks department wants to do. It makes me think, it's like, well, what is it? Is it for the kids or is it for politics? What is it? You people have to start putting the kids first.
And that's all.
Yeah, but when you see something in a political site, this is what they were going to do, and all of a sudden you do this stuff.
And trying to see what the program is all about, I guarantee you can thank us.
Well, the other one's already got deposits of people coming to her program.
Okay. Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done. Okay. Don't worry. You do know there's going to be repercussions, right? Hey,
whatever will be, will be.
Hi, good evening. My name is Michelle Russo, and I am at 639 Kingsland Ave. How are you? So, my question is...
You're not on the list here, ma'am.
Oh, I have to register?
You're supposed to, yes.
Okay. Can I speak at the end of the meeting, or just before this, or do you accept sign-ins?
What's your name and what's your name?
Sure. My name is Michelle Lorenzo. Lorenco, 639 Kingsland Ave. Okay. So, I am new to town, and my kids will be starting pre-K-4 and the fourth grade in September. And one of the attractive things about Lyndhurst, other than the referendum that was passed, was also the availability of before and after care. So at the moment, I am a mom on a mission, and I am very much interested in learning about what this transition means for the children. And I understand you're planning to look out for the best interest in the student, the children, but my real question is, today when you're voting, are you voting for the removal of the current program or a removal or voting for the replacement of the current program? because if it's for a replacement, since I seem to understand it's the Parks Department that's going to run it, then you should have an idea of how it's going to happen and what's going to occur. So I really just wanted to be enlightened and have a little bit more information, just so that I can be a little bit at ease come September, because childcare is very important and it's very difficult to find.
Well, once whoever is going to be awarded the program,
right,
you will be more than free to contact them and find out, and they'll be willing to share everything that they have about running the program, and I'm sure that you will be shocked.
Can I suggest that we give everybody an overview of the program?
If that would be possible, that would be great, because it is 2 months and it does take some time to plan for before care, especially.
So we're not getting highly specific, because from an attorney perspective, I would rather let the attorney lead the way. But I will let you know, again, this is a board decision, but as superintendent, I'm in those executive sessions. They last extremely long, sometimes well beyond 3 hours. So I will tell you that my role is to make sure that it is about the students, and it's also about our community. And that's something that I really pride myself on. So some of the items that we looked at was certainly not to give anything less, but to give more. So when we were looking at programs, who could continue to give the hours that were offered now, and who could perhaps give more hours? Another piece that was looked at was the availability of different family situations, family needs. So instead of having a limitation on what parents could select from, be it how many days, and then have that cost, make sure that parents have the opportunity to have more programs to select from and keep costs down. And then finally, that third big factor was, how can we give parents either the same number of hours or more hours, the same types of activities or more activities, and put more money into their pockets? In some of the options that we were given, there was also more self-sufficiency, so a little less dependency on the district. What does that do for us? That frees up some of the things that otherwise may be relied upon. For example, if a program can be more self-sufficient in transportation, and we now can have access to a bus or two for the ability to bring sports teams to where they need to go, well, that's going to come in a savings of anywhere between $200 and $300 per trip for us. Likewise, if there is a program that is willing to offer revenue to the district for use of the district facilities, then that's another means of us generating money, which ultimately is giving back to the kids. So again, without getting into any of the specific comparisons, I always say, when we're hiring staff, when we're looking at programs, how awesome when we have everything so wonderful that anyone would do, and now we're just picking the best of the bunch. That happens when we're hiring people, it happens when we're looking at programs, it happens when we're looking at services. So essentially, those were the factors that I can tell you this board looked at as they examined the pieces.
Okay, so the next board meeting is at the end of August. So this will have to be resolved well before then. So if you're voting on it tonight, when do you think the information will be passed out to the community?
So as soon as the board makes a decision, if that happens to be tonight, if they come to a consensus and they're able to move forward with the vote, then my immediate next steps would be to form a communication process with whatever group is selected to offer those programs. We'll then talk about our needs, we'll get everything codified, and we'll start promoting that program's registration, just as we have always done with the previous program. We've always fostered the ability to get literature out on their behalf. We will certainly continue to do that. Likewise, we will also serve as a liaison for parents when they have questions, so they can either go to the group themselves, and if they're not getting their answers there, they can certainly come to us. And over the years, I have, as both principal and superintendent, I've had lots of communication with parents about their after and before care needs, and we're always looking to help resolve those.
Okay, and would this include pre-K? Four?
This RFQ went out for pre-K through 8. So we did extend it on this one.
All right, I look forward to hearing. Thank you.
And welcome to the community.
Finance Committee, Mr. Grillo.
Any board member who takes exception to any of the following listed actions under the category of Finance, Facilities, and District Planning Committee may so indicate now. A separate motion for each of the accepted actions will be entertained. 41? We're going to do 1 through 40 and 42 to 43. We'll leave 41 out.
Then you're going to do 41, and then 42 and 43 again.
Okay. Okay. Everybody got that? 1 through 40. Right. Okay. Zach, do I have a motion?
Roll call.
You made the motion. Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andronopoulos.
4.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis.
4.
Ms. Mallon.
4.
Mr. Musto.
4.
Mr. Bruno.
4.
Okay, now 41, 42, 43.
Item 41 first. Okay, so Mr. Grillo made the motion for 41. He needs a second.
Second.
Roll call.
Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andronopoulos.
4.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis. Ms. Mallon. Mr. Musto? Mr. Bruno?
Abstain.
And now, 42 and 43.
Second.
Roll call.
Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andronopoulos.
4.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis.
4.
Ms. Mallon.
4.
Mr. Musto.
4.
Mr. Bruno.
Abstain. Ms. Alcuri.
Education and curriculum. Any board member who takes exception to any of the following listed actions under the category of education and curriculum committee may so indicate now, and a separate motion for each of the accepted actions will be entertained. Hearing none, I make a motion that numbers 1 and 2 be approved.
Roll call.
Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andronopoulos.
4.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis.
4.
Ms. Malinak.
4.
Mr. Musto.
4.
Mr. Bruno.
4.
Chris Thomas. Policies, rules, and regulations. Any board member who takes exception to any of the following listed actions under the category of policy, rules, and regulations committee may so indicate now, and separate motion for each of the accepted actions will be entertained. Hearing none, I make a motion to accept the committee's action on board numbers 1 through 6.
Second.
Roll call.
Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andronopoulos.
4.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis.
4.
Ms. Mallon.
4.
Mr. Musto.
4.
Mr. Bruno.
4.
Hearing none, I make a motion to approve Zupcher.
Four.
Mr. Angelopoulos.
Four.
Mr. Donovan.
Four.
Mr. Grillo.
Four.
Ms. Jarvis.
Four.
Ms. Mallon.
Four.
Mr. Musto.
Four.
Mr. Bruno.
Four.
Any board member who takes exception to any of the following listed actions under the category of new business may so indicate now, and a separate motion for each of the accepted actions will be entertained. I make a motion that 2, 3, and 4 be accepted.
Second. Roll call.
Ms. Alcure.
Four.
Mr. Andrianopoulos.
Four.
Mr. Donovan.
Four.
Mr. Grillo.
Four.
Ms. Jarvis.
Four.
Ms. Malinak.
Four.
Mr. Musto.
Just like to say, hopefully, this is almost like Obamacare. We have to vote on it before you get to see what's actually in the plan. I'm a little upset by that. We should probably have put on some.
This is
2, 3, 4.
New business number one, and since I'm the first one to vote,
Master.
We have a second.
I want to make a statement because I don't want anyone to think that I wouldn't put the children in this community first. I gave 43 years of my life as an educator, and now five years on the Board of Education, actually four. So with that, I studied all three proposals. I had questions, and I asked them to people, and they were answered. So this is my statement regarding my vote. After much research and inquiry regarding the three bids presented to the for the 2017-2018 before and after care program, my decision was based upon what I believe to be the best for the students of the Lyndhurst Public School District, on a program equal to or better than the existing program, on additional revenue afforded to the Board of Education for the usage of our facilities, and on a cost savings factor of $1,303.01 per child yearly for the parents. My decision is for number one.
Mr. Andrianopoulos.
Four.
Mr. Donovan.
No.
Mr. Grillo.
Four.
Ms. Jarvis.
Four.
Ms. Mallon.
Four.
Mr. Musto.
The plan that you're voting for right now, we're voting yes for, the cost for taking $25,000 from the township and bringing it over to the Board of Education, it's hardly a savings to the taxpayer. There's a plan in here. There's a plan in here from the YMCA. They're looking to give us $15,000. That's non-tax money coming into the Board of Ed. New revenue. That's savings. That's new revenue. That's something we can use. They're an existing plant. They're an existing facility. They have something going on. They have other after-school programs. I thought, by far, their plan is the best. It wasn't even given consideration. I believe it wasn't given consideration because, as somebody said earlier, it is a political issue. The other thing I have an issue with, and I'd like to ask you directly, Mr. President, did you have a conversation with the chief of police when you told him that in the 2017-18 year that his wife's program will be in place?
I had a conversation with him, and I told him that it probably would be in place, but at the time, there were no other programs put forth, okay? This was done at a diner, okay?
That's how most of the business in Lyndhurst is done.
Well, it was done at the diner, and it was done under a lot of duress and a lot of pressure. And
you were under pressure?
Yeah, quite a bit. And I have one of my board members who was at the meeting that night had to escort me from the thing. Because I was at a dinner, okay, that all of this started happening. I didn't know anything, I didn't know this lady, I didn't know whose husband or whatever it was, and I get a phone call all day, and the last thing I heard was, this, what you're doing is going to be actionable. Now, this is by a public figure who shouldn't be involved at all if it was taking place, especially pressuring the president of the Board of Education. Well,
while sitting at that diner, you have no authority.
Okay. We don't want to be involved.
While sitting at the diner, you have no authority back on that.
I didn't act. Okay, we have to vote, but I didn't act on it. I was defending myself. No, you weren't at that time.
Mr. Bruno.
Four.
Motion carries.
Personnel. You can go to the room.
Any board member takes exception to any of the following listed actions under the category of personnel. They so indicate now, and a separate motion for each of the accepted actions will be entertained. Chris, one and two. Okay, we're going to go three through. So we're going to go 3 to 46. Have a second.
Second.
Okay, this is personnel items 3 to 46. Ms. Alcarri.
Four.
Mr. Andrianopoulos.
Four.
Mr. Donovan.
Four.
Mr. Grillo.
Four.
Ms. Jordan.
Four.
Ms. Malinak.
Four.
Mr. Musto.
Four.
Mr. Bruno.
Four.
Do I have a motion for one and two now?
Second.
Mr. Grillo. Mr. Grillo made the motion. Ms. Alcarri second. Items 1 and 2. Ms. Alcuri.
4.
Mr. Andrianopoulos.
Oh.
Mr. Donovan.
4.
Mr. Grillo.
4.
Ms. Jarvis.
4.
Ms. Malinak.
4.
Mr. Musto.
4.
Mr. Bruno.
4.
Motion carries.
Can we please have a round of applause for all of you? It truly is a testament to the work of the district, to our increasing enhancements and improvements, because it just makes the decision making so much harder for us. But we are very confident that we have picked the best of the best to service our students, to lead our district, and to be proud representatives of our community, because we are only part of the greater whole. So again, we look forward to the work that we'll be doing together, and to all of those people who were confirmed tonight, our sincere congratulations. You worked really hard for this, so seize this accomplishment. Congratulations.
Alani, non agenda. Marcy, negotiate.
Let's talk about the air conditioning in Franklin School when it got really hot. That in August, you supposedly had, service record. In August of 2016, in September, we were supposed to have it fixed. The hot days we had, the class in Franklin School had no air conditioning. So explain to me how ticket is sent to someone to fix it in August, and when the hot part of 2017, months later, it wasn't fixed.
So what are you talking about, a window unit, or are you talking about the HVAC?
I think it was a window unit.
The kindergarten class, the unit went bad, and you couldn't find a replacement because of the opening in the cutout of the window.
Okay, so you couldn't get an air conditioning or fix it from August to the following June?
Didn't know about it in August, okay? I did not know about it in August.
Okay.
I found out about it in November. It was on order. We couldn't get it. It's in the maintenance garage right now. It's going to be replaced.
Okay.
I walked every single room last week, okay, and took an inventory of it.
And how many more were there?
It was five in the district. Out of 100 rooms, there were five.
So there was five kids that had to sweat.
No, they relocated, okay?
Yeah, I understand that.
Okay.
Well, you know, in the real world, that stuff doesn't happen.
Excuse me?
In the real world, it gets fixed. In the real business, it gets fixed for the employees. So maybe you should check all your things to make sure that it is not months and months and months. Thank you.
This one I'm about to read is a public statement. It's on behalf of the Board of Education. It's in reference to negotiations. Representatives of the Lyndhurst Board of Education and informally with representatives of the Lyndhurst Education Association in an attempt to reach agreement on a successor contract to the current contract between the parties. At the first formal joint meeting between the Board Negotiating Committee and the Association Negotiation Committee held on February 1st, 2016, the parties agreed on ground rules for the negotiation process and agreed on current salary information. However, prior to the parties exchanging their proposals for changes to the contract, the Association declared impasse and requested that the process be moved to mediated sessions through the Public Employment Relations Commission of Northwest Park. The Association declared it as at its earliest stages of negotiations for the stated reason that the Board would not consider changes to the Chapter 78 schedule of employee health benefit maintenance. The Association's position on the subject is not consistent with settlements throughout the state of New Jersey. According to the New Jersey School Board Association, only 19 of the 586 districts in the state have agreed to changes in the employee Chapter 78 maintenance. In Bergen County, there is only one district to modify the Chapter 78 payments. After the declaration of impasse, the parties participated in mediation through FERC. The Board made a very generous offer to the Association, including raises of many rates, not just the salary. For salary increases, the Board offered the following. For the 2016-17 school year, a 2.7 increase. For 17-18 school year, a 2.5 increase. For the 18-19 school year, a 2.5. In addition, the Board offered a approximate 42.86 increase in lunch duty pay, an hourly increase from $28 an hour to $83.33 per 3-hour block of curriculum writing over the summer, and a similar hourly increase from $28 an hour to $87.50 for a 4-hour block of curriculum writing over the summer, and between 50% and 150% increases for attendance bonuses. The Board also offered to divide an additional 0.57% of salary, or $90,000, among those employees who are subject to the Chapter 78 point payments towards health insurance in an effort to help defray the impact of those payments on the Lyndhurst employees. The Association rejected the generous offer made by the Board and instead chooses to move the negotiation process to a fact-finding hearing. Regardless of the Association's past refusal to actively participate in the negotiation process, the Board remains optimistic that a settlement will be reached with a new contract. The Board cannot agree to an unreasonable or financially unsound position of the Association. The issue is reaching an agreement that is fair to the employees, consistent with the Board's obligations to the taxpayers, and is in keeping with the needs of the students' first couple of months.
Motion to adjourn.
Joseph. Yes, sir. We're good.